gluten-free because a lot of us who are gluten-free have a number of recipes and sometimes write our own recipes. So there was a really interesting article in the Wall Street Journal, and it's called Chefs Solve a Modern Kitchen Crisis, Recipe Clutter. And she talked about all these different ways that these professional chefs store their recipes. So I kind of wanted to share it with you and then hopefully get some feedback from you guys about how you actually store your recipes. So it opens up with this question that is there a better way to collect and store recipes so they can be easily retrieved later on? It says, even the pros struggle. Most chefs rely on some combination of digital readers, apps, and emails. And I love this. After his $1,200 laptop got totally fried in a spill of red wine, Joseph Guillard, executive chef at the Napa Valley Grill in Los Angeles, knew he needed a cheaper yet more reliable way to access his 250 recipes in the kitchen. So he began using his Kindle, first purchasing e-versions of dozens of cookbooks from his personal collection so he could pull up recipes quickly when needed, for example, when training employees. I'm using it as a mobile reference library, says Mr. Guillard. As for recipes he writes himself, he emails them to himself so he can get them onto the Kindle too. Now he's debating upgrading to an iPad, which he plans to perch on a kitchen stand and connect to a fast internet connection. You go, Joseph. And then Brad Barnes, who's a senior director of culinary education at the Culinary Institute of America in Hyde Park, New York, co-founded GigaChef.com in 2007, and that's GIGACHEF.com, which is a free website where chefs can share and organize recipes. Users, many but not all of them professionals, can access recipes with space to type notes at the end, plus an ingredient library and food industry job descriptions, which I think is really cool. And then another person, it says, what's the secret ingredient in a good organization system? And then the response was categories. Mr. Esnault sorts his recipes according to main ingredient, fish, meat, vegetable, placing each recipe document into a color-coded file on his computer desktop. Fiona Faulkner, a cookbook author based in Somerset, England, says it's important that categories fit your lifestyle. Her folders have titles like Comfort Food Lunches, Impress Some Weekend Dishes, and Back on the Wagon for diet-friendly options. It makes more sense to me that way, she says. For cooks researching or writing their own recipes, sites like Delicious or Evernote offer tools for recording, storing, and retrieving on many different devices. I'm obsessed with Evernote. I use Evernote all the time. I have it on my iPad, on my phone, on my computer. I access it remotely. It is an awesome app, and I'm pretty sure it's free. So just think about that. Targeted apps like RecipeBox make it easier to transfer recipes on the web from one site to another. Using another app, Big Oven, users can snap a photo of a print recipe and the app converts it to text that the user can edit. That's really cool. I wonder how much that app costs. At the bottom, it talks about how some chefs refuse to give up old school methods. For many chefs, these involve a pocket-sized notebook made by Moleskine with plastic-coated covers and an elastic bookmark. Rob White, the dean of the Culinary Institute of Michigan, has filled more than 300 with recipes, each one with a sketch of a dish or plating idea on the back. So obviously there's not one way to do it right, but I thought those were really interesting. I'd never heard of GigaChef. I'd never heard of Big Oven or Recipe Box. So I think that's awesome. I don't write a ton of recipes. I write a couple, and I usually do them handwritten on a little in a recipe box. But I think it's always good to have stuff always at your fingertips where you can always have it always accessible to you, especially when you're out and people say, oh my gosh, how'd you do this? Or, you know, what was that special sauce you made? You can pull it up on Evernote or something. So those were just interesting. And if you guys have a special way that you keep your recipes, I'd love to hear. Leave me a comment. I think it'd be kind of cool to figure out what you guys do. So my mom has this like recipe box that just has like stuff just flying out of it. Like there's no organization. I don't know how she finds things, but she always manages to. So everyone has a system. But anyway, I hope everyone's doing well out there. And as always, it's from Have Nots Having Gluten-Free Dining. Thanks for watching.